con la famiglia, con le ragazze che sono state queste fatte, con la Wii, con la Madonna, con il wifi, con il
app.
Yeah. Everybody's left their own devices. It showed the work for 9 in the morning, to, you know, maybe 10 in the morning, to 7 at night, and then we were sitting up to 4 in the morning just talking, and, you know, and really, it woke me up to how good that is, just to spend time. You see, but the thing is, everybody there, we weren't the time banking, but there was a time banking spirit was there. You know, people of that kind of essence were all there, and we were all spending time together. And you take away Wi-Fi, you take away the drink, what a difference. I mean, everybody just had to concentrate on being themselves. And then once they came out of being shy, but the first couple of days everyone was kind of shy, nobody's having a drink. Once people got confidence to be themselves, it's amazing. Yeah. So the time back in spirit was there, you know, people were in the space to be themselves. And that's what I got. I came home, you know, I don't drink anyway. And I know that you're going to be drinking a great time, but I came home feeling just so good about that.
And remember, Lena, she sent an email, she's like, I've got drunk without a cup. Yeah. She just, and it's true, we were behaving.
It's very encouraging, I think, because I travel around and people from time bikes, and always the concern is about people who potentially are going to be left behind because they don't use the futures for all sorts of reasons. And you know, obviously we're kind of embracing software and it's going to help a lot of time backs. But at the same time, you know, if people don't have an email account or they're not on Facebook or they don't use websites and stuff, how are they going to interact? I think just listening to the feedback I've heard about this conference is just getting people together in the same room to generate that experience where they can exchange and make connections with each other is really what it's about. And I think the danger is losing that when we kind of become that virtual. Because I think our virtual communication in a way is like it's much more distant. Like most of the time I communicate with my mum by email, which is completely ridiculous, isn't it? Yeah. But like even in my last job, we would literally email each other when we sat opposite each other because we had almost lost the art of communicating with each other because there were so many pressures on us to get stuff done fast. And then, you know, I sometimes think about how little I use the phone now, and I tend to email people rather than use the phone. It's just like that, listening to people's voices and you hear the intonation in their voices and you can tell that somebody's a bit low on the phone, or you can tell they're really static on the phone. You don't pick that up in an email. You can cover up quite a lot of your, you know, feelings in an email. So I think
it's funny you say that because it's like, in a way, social media, which is great, right? Social media in a way is kind of productive to what we're trying to do in time banking in most sense. It's another discussion, right? But in some ways it is because, you know, you take away that side there, where you can't just disappear to your room and go on Skype home and just talk to people at home for 2 hours, and you're stuck having to be a human being yourself, naked, or with clothes on, you know what I mean? Naked human being and have to be yourself and cope with that. To do that for a week was amazing. If I had Wi-Fi, I would have been going to bed at 8 o'clock to watch Netflix, House of Cards. You know, that's what I would have been doing, definitely, you know. I would have been walking.
I was going to make you a second more question, but it's actually the same email. That's not the institute next to you. I am going to make sure that is a second more question. There are some learning in terms of facilitating a, and also the other thing is, Sarah at first, because I had to really work with Sarah. She said, calm. And at the years while I said, calm down, you know, to be saying, because I couldn't explain. I've been there before. You can't explain what it is. You know, I know it's going to be good and I know it's going to be fun, but you can't. I can tell you this, but you know, but actually a week away, and Sarah was saying a week away before the conference. Yeah. And I'm thinking a week away, yeah. But actually, we did a lot in a week. 3 days would have been different, because actually if it had been 3 days, by day three, that would have been when we were just about getting to the thing. And a week was just about right, you know. So you need the time, and you had no Wi-Fi, no middle of the way. There was not even a town, there were some houses over there, when there was a cow in the field. There wasn't a cow, we thought it was a cow. Because we went for walks at night. There's no lights, so it's just stars, it's snow, you get used to it, but so we went for walks, it's just snow everywhere, there's nothing out. There's no village, there's nowhere to go. And so you have to crack on, and of course, if there's nowhere to go, you talk to people. That's what you do, so you go for a walk, we went for walks at lunch, in the evenings, some went swimming. They wanted us to go. There was something again on TV by Marco Petillo about the banyan. It's so the Russian, they love this illness, and they don't understand if you don't have good banyan. It's called banyan. And I have never done it yet. I've been somewhere here, but never in Russia. But you have, and I think you're almost a family if you don't cook the banyan. But there was banyan there. But there was too much to do, just to have time. There was so much going on, we didn't have time to go swimming or to go to banyan. Because it was just so much fun and stuff. And I think time banking, in fact, it was my, you know, at the US time, the conference that you had, there was an excerpt from Martin's book about how to make a time bank work. And there's my 20th. And then someone said there's something missing there. There was a step missing. And it's fun. It has to be fun. If it's not fun, you won't have it, and that was fun. You've got to have fun when you're doing it, and how you create it. It's fun, the little touches, but it's okay. It's verbal communication, obviously, rather than emails or telephone. But this, little notes, very powerful. In fact, I've actually been. I was running another group years ago with a bunch of women, and it was exclusively for women, but I was part of it. Design the package, and we created at the end of the workshops for the women, that you created a little book, and then you wrote something. So you had a book for you, for Karen's book, and I put some, and then I pass it on, and then put something for you, and then a little book. It was like this, you know. But little touches like this. And you know, for a time to work, you've got a lot of people, and you've got to have some fun. It's a system to save money or to change something. Yeah, I don't think it's enough. For someone to find significance in your belonging, you've got to put in the love. And little touches just make you feel very special. Even, Simon, this guy from Ukraine, I did bring some chocolates because I actually like chocolates really good. But I bought some sweets and some chocolate, and I gave him. I found out he loves. There was some chocolate sharing. People were sharing chocolate. I had kept mine because my chocolate I had saved for some individuals that I already knew. So I thought, there's a bar for Olga. There was three Olgas: Olga number one, Olga number two, Olga number three. I know Olga number one, and Olga number two, and Olga number three is from the Czech Republic. But I knew because I met it before, you bring something. So it's tea, chocolates, of course. And I'm going to take candles, chocolates, isn't it? So I have my chocolate bars assigned to some individuals. But I have found out from Simon that he just loves chocolate. So I gave him a bar of chocolate. Mm. So, you know, a bar of chocolate. You know, it was just like, it was token of love, you know, and it gave me pleasure to give to it, you know. So we must remember the life of the time bank, it has to be written in love. For me, if it's not love, I'm not interested. It's another system. So I don't know what else. It's really this, what I'm sharing there is an experience rather than some. One thing that we also decided to do. And there are so many decisions made, and there are some good jobs that have come out of it. We were thinking about how do you how do you educate? No, I don't like the word educate, it's very patronising, but how do people learn about the town bank, how it works, what they do? And we thought of designing some videos and have some homebrew videos. So we could, across the network, create little videos. So on Wednesday night at my house, there will be food and you can watch a little video. There are loads of videos out there. Everyone's doing it, church is doing it, you know, people doing their videos, and there's a talk afterwards, an hour long usually. But we thought that would be a good way of creating a network of experiences on video, so you bring people over to your house, a couple of hours one evening, when it suits the crew, and then you watch a little video, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, and you learn some nuggets. So we thought that would be one way, a new non-way of learning across the network. So that was one thing that we also thought we would be doing amongst the tons of things that we want to do. That really probably is. The new model of time making. Families. Okay, we talked about person to person, person to organization, organization to organization. Now we're talking about with the time making.
Yeah.
Families. The whole family. That's time making. The whole family looks after neighbors. The whole family goes, there's a guy. The whole family earns credits. And that's just different because actually what came through again, the family unit is so important. And even yesterday, a couple of days ago, the Sherry designer Sherry, it was Sarah, the guy was speaking there, Professor someone, I can't remember that, great guy. He said that actually the sharing, the habit of sharing starts at a young age. The child will pick up the good and the bad at that age. If the child is taught, don't share it, don't give out special, don't, that's what they will do. On the other hand, if the child is encouraged to share and to take some risks, whatever, it will become more of a habit for them. And so the idea would be to, something we need to work through is how do we engage a whole family in this? How does a family together decide to do time banking, together make a decision, rather than the dad say, I will go into the garden for this lady down the road, and mum stays at home, and how does the whole family, or maybe the children go into it, but the family's involved in the decision making. Very different.
Just for jumping in, how often have you heard me before? And then the biggest thing for me was with the family was being able to do it again. So we did six, maybe four kids. Me and my wife, three of during the time when we were able to do things for each other, what I mean is in terms of, so if I went out and earned some time credits, you know, I could give them to my son to do something the week after. We could do them as a family, so we have a pool, family pool of credits.
Yeah.
When any of us need to do something or need something, we can ask them, you know, dip into that pool of credits. And maybe it's with another family, you know, maybe
yeah.
You have breakfast for school, so at school some kids will get breakfast club, so we could be the breakfast club for another family. So their kids come here in the morning,
yeah.
they get breakfast with your kids,
yeah.
And then they all go to school together, yeah. And you have a wee friendship thing, and then maybe it's dinner, so we're working late, so our kids are able to go to the other family's house for something to eat, and you get families starting to do things together because of that, so you're talking.
Well, two families decide to go to a garden.
Okay. So you do a garden together or help each other. Two families go and do another family's garden. And I just went, I said, Tracy, that's never occurred to me. That's really good. I'm capable of that.
And now that this idea comes from Russia. So who are we to tell Russia to time again? Because we're learning some stuff from there. It's quite something. We actually had a meeting with the... Because we did go to Nizhny for a day. I had said to them, I said, look, first thing I said, sharing bedrooms is not a good issue to do. We're going to have problems there. And I said, if we're 1 week away in the middle of a place, we need to go to Nizhny. We love the whole place. We need to go downtown and have a room. So we had a day out in Nizhny. And it's on TV, by the way. It's on TV. We had we'd organized for us to meet the Minister of Culture or whatever. So, and we were greeted with people dressed up. And we have bread and salt, that's traditional. And then this minister comes up and had a speech about the city of Nishni, who lived there and stuff like that. And then we had a walk. We went to one of the Russian Orthodox Church. We walked around. We went to an amazing meal in the oldest restaurant in town. That's twice I've been there, the oldest place in town. Before that, come after that, we also met, we had a meeting with the town makers on Nishni. And the idea was, so we were all around the table. Well, that was a bit more formal at first. And it was, and the idea was to, we had to go around, we had to, Natalia gave us, to, we had to go and meet five people and tell them something about the town. And then you find out, when Nishni, they, and they're doing that, like, you know, they're helping each other out, they're doing a little task with each other and stuff like that. And, you know, and one of the girls I met there, I said, so I kind of run out of questions to ask, and I said, can you tell me what Tamaki is? She just came out, just like, she said, Tamaki is this, is shared skills, the core values, stuff like that, and this is what we do. Why was I reacting like this? Why was I thinking, why? Because in my preconceived mind, I'm thinking they couldn't possibly know. It's terrible, really. No, they got it. So, you know, there's a lot of money. So what we're going to be doing, network, European network, common declaration, and then we're going to work on exchanges, because there's a lot of volunteering in Russia, and just in Europe is quite big, and Erasmus Plus does a lot of exchanges, and that's what they do in Nishni. They send people out. They have people coming to Nishni. Marius is one of them, from Greece, and what's his name? Oh, the first facilitator. Lucas had been there. You go basically across Europe, you go spend a year or whatever in a different country, and you volunteer, you do stuff. So, what we want to do is to have the ability, particularly here, to bring some of them over here to work with us. So I'm already working on having two this summer. I'll find a way, because I want that energy in my time. I really want it. I'll find some other way. But the idea would be to bring, and it could be people from us going over there, but because it's the cultural exposure and the learning is phenomenal. And so, and I know, for example, if I get one or two workers, they all look